Good morning, students. Now we will start our next point. See, yesterday we started our new lesson, that is air around us. Okay, so in this lesson, what we discussed, I told you to complete two activities. Maybe you have completed that activities. Okay, so now the next point it is, that is the composition of air. Now see, everyone, you know that so many gases are present nearby us. Means this air is a mixture of gases. Okay, so which gases are present in the air? That is oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide and other gases. These all are the present in the air. So now these all the gases, how many percentage they are present in the air, that now we will see. See here, the first one, it is a nitrogen. See in your textbook, one activity it is a given, means the air, in the air oxygen is a present. How we come to know that the oxygen is present? For that the activity is given, means candle. Jital, oxygen is present in the air. So two candles and that one a glass, and when candle will not get the oxygen, so it stops burning. Okay, see here, the picture is shown. This is very simple activity. This activity also you can perform. Why now I am not showing here? Because already the Jital, shown you, and nicely she has explained this point also. So oxygen is present in the air. Now see, the next point means what? This nitrogen, how many percentage of nitrogen is present? See, oxygen is very essential for us, okay, but the nitrogen is present most of the part, means maximum amount of nitrogen is present, 78%. 78% nitrogen is present. But see, this nitrogen we are not using the directly. Okay, what means this nitrogen, the nitrogen fixation and so many points are there, and then that nitrogen, after the nitrogen fixation, when we are eating the fruits and vegetable, from that we are getting the nitrogen. Okay, so the maximum amount means about 78% nitrogen is present in the air. See, the is neither burn itself nor support the process of burning. See how the oxygen is support burning, okay, it does not burn itself. So the like that the characteristics are different each gas. So now this nitrogen gas, see what it is, the property, see, it is neither burn itself nor supports burning. Means what? It is neither burn itself and nor supports burning. Then see the oxygen. Oxygen present 21%. And what is the importance of oxygen? You all have known. Okay, oxygen is very important for all the living things, because the respiration process is totally depend on the oxygen. Okay, so oxygen is very essential for us. Means while we are doing the respiration. Okay, so that oxygen we are taking, and we given out the carbon dioxide. So oxygen is very important for us as well as for the plants and animals also. So means this is the importance of oxygen, and it present around 21%. Okay, now the next which gas, carbon dioxide. See the carbon dioxide, very less amount, that is 0.03% carbon dioxide is present. Very after the carbon dioxide means 0.1, 0.2, like that also other gases are present. Okay, so the carbon dioxide means when we exhale, okay, while inhaling process we are taking oxygen, but when we exhale, that time the carbon dioxide gas is produce. Okay, so the percentage of carbon dioxide gas is 0.03%. then next, see water vapors. Water vapors, now you know, while the evaporation process, water convert into a gaseous state. So water vapor, that is only known as the water vapors present in the air, and that is only known as a humidity. Okay, see, the amount of water vapor present in the air is called as a humidity. Okay, and dust particles and smoke, dust particles. Now, how we come to know that dust is present? So, air is moving fast, it is known as a wind. Okay, so that time we can see the dust, but now here we cannot see the dust particles. But while the inhaling process, sometimes what happens, we feel the dust comes inside our nose. Okay, so the dust particles and smoke is also present in the air. Okay, so this is the composition of air, means which components are present in the air, and some other gases also present in the air. Very simple activities are given, that activities we will do in our next lecture. So today what you have to do, you read this point and write some important notes in your chemistry notebook. Okay, so now we will stop here. Next time we will continue our next point. Thank you.